Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Welcome back to Cocktails After Dark. We're going to do another cocktail from David Embry's The Fine Art of Mixing Drinks. Today, we're going to do a rum cocktail called The Third Rail. But instead of doing it with two different rums, I'm going to do one with gin because Mr. Embry, who loves to... I mean, this book is all about drawing lines between cocktails. If you change one thing, it becomes this. So he says, some recipes call for gin instead of rum, and of course, the drink then becomes a Bronx. Pure and simple. So, I'm going to do one with rum, one with gin, and we'll compare the two and we'll see what happens. So he calls for French vermouth, which is white vermouth or dry vermouth, depending on what you want to call it. Then he calls for Italian vermouth, which is red or sweet, depending on what you want to call it. Then, same amount of orange juice. Freshly squeezed, of course. Next we come to the rum. Gold Label Rum is what he calls for. And reading at the beginning, Gold Label Rum to him meant a rum that spent some time in some barrel and has some barrel aging. So I'm going to use this Diplomático. It's a Venezuelan rum. Works quite well in cocktails. So we're going to do 3 ounces of rum in this shaker. Oh, just enough. And then I'm going to use Dylan's Dry Gin number 7 in this shaker. And so this is a local gin. It's made from rye grain. It's quite nice. And 3, and I will ice and shake these one at a time. And a double strain. Hey, Jules.
Hey, Glenn. Hey, friends. What do we have today?
So, we have two cocktails.
This one is distinctly different.
This one is the Third Rail. Okay. It is rum. This one is the Bronx. It is gin. It is the same cocktail, just a different base spirit.
So their names make me, are they subway related? Like, do they have mass transit related? Like, going out to the Bronx
On the subway with the Third Rail? Don't touch the Third Rail? I don't know. So I thought because David Embry draws a very distinct straight line between the two, I thought we would compare them and see what that difference means.
Sure. That's a lovely ginny drink. Love it.
I mean,
is a lovely drink as well. I mean, they are completely different, of course.
As expected, completely different base spirits. Which one would I like more? I don't know.
Well,
I think so.
I have a complete bias towards gin, so let's not kid ourselves. But they are both
really good.
Really good.
Really good. And of course, if you've ever watched any of our videos, you know that if you just switch out
one thing,
it starts to change. So, I mean, a different gin. This isn't going to make it gin forward gin. It's a very gin forward gin, right? It's more human than human. A more subtle gin would certainly change the flavor completely.
Yeah, a dry gin, a London dry would taste different. The couple of the ones that we have from Quebec that are like
northern botanicals, yeah. And then again with the rum, I mean, if you use a different, this is a Venezuelan rum, it has a very different characteristic than.
So I think the one observation I'll make is that in both instances, the liquor has a strong influence on the outcome.
Yes.
So this is where you pick your favorite.
Yes.
Right?
These other things, the other three ingredients are definitely background players.
Yes.
They don't jump out. Orange doesn't jump out. The vermouth doesn't jump out. Okay. Third Rail in the Bronx. Both good cocktails. Worth exploring. separately with their own concoctions and, you know, play with the vermouth and maybe just use jugged orange juice from the grocery store.
That's okay, too.
That's fine, too. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.